Tell everybody your name and what do you do?
My name is Kahari Mosley. I'm the National Political Director for the League of Young Voters and the League of Young Voters Education Fund.
Now, you're one of the people that was here earlier on for the hip-hop political convention, former rapper who used to open up for the Roots. Right?
Absolutely, absolutely.
But you're also an elected official now, right?
Yes.
Tell everybody, what's the position you hold in the city of Pittsburgh?
I'm the chairman of the 22nd Ward in the city of Pittsburgh, serving my first full term. I was elected in late 2004 to fulfill an unexpired term of my predecessor, and then I was elected to a full term in 2006, and I'm toward the end of my first full term.
Let me ask you, between your work as in hip-hop and your work now in the political system, is hip-hop a movement? And if so, why so? And if not, what's required to make it a movement?
I think it absolutely is a movement. We've seen, at least in my lifetime, even, from the early 80s until now, watching the integral role hip-hop has played in this country's, moving forward from a lot of the challenges that we face, bringing young people together. Like, if you look around at this crowd right now, you see the level of diversity. You think about, what happened, last November with the election and all the young people from all backgrounds getting behind President Obama. I think that's directly related to hip-hop. We have a lot of young people of all backgrounds who grew up admiring African Americans, looking at them as leaders, whether it's Chuck D or KRS-One or Queen Latifah or MC Light, all the way down the line to Tupac and Biggie. So we have a whole generation of young Americans who have no issue with looking at African Americans as leaders, cultural icons.
Is that a byproduct, or is that the result of this being a movement? I mean, people, you could say that about soul and other music as well. Is that a byproduct of that, or is there a difference between like being a movement like Martin Luther King leading the charge to get a goal accomplished? What's the goal that hip-hop is getting accomplished?
I think the goal that hip-hop is getting accomplished is bringing folks together and showing, how much we're more alike than we are different, and I think, this movement, isn't like the civil rights movement. It's not going to take the same shape or the same form. Those were different times. And what we're seeing, instead of one mass movement with one individual leader, what we're seeing is young people all over the country taking initiative, people running for office, people getting involved in global issues like Darfur and Tibet. You see people getting involved with local issues like public transportation, and open space, green space, gentrification issues in the Bay Area, to open government issues of transparency in Pittsburgh, violence in Philadelphia. So what we're seeing is young people, not looking for one singular leader to rally around, but taking, the energy and the whole spirit of the music and what hip hop was, about, in the 70s and the 80s and the early 90s, and taking that all the way into this millennium and moving it forward and figuring out ways to make a difference for themselves as opposed to one leader or one specific movement. I think it's really birth movements all over the country and all over the world.
Okay, tell everybody your name.
Peace, my name is Jared Ball. I'm assistant professor of communication studies at Morgan State University, an independent journalist with Pacifica and Free Mix Radio, and Black Agenda Report starting soon, and former presidential, attempted to get the presidential nomination from the Green Party, and I stepped back to support Cynthia McKinney and Rosa Clemente in 2008.
We're talking about movements, and this is something that you study a lot, and this is a part of where you're at. When we talk about hip-hop as a movement, can you talk about whether or not that's a true case and contrasting that with movements of the past from Marcus Garvey, the anti-war, the free speech movement, civil rights movement, Black Panthers and all that? How do you contrast that?
Well, I mean, I think the easiest thing to contrast is the difference in the times. I think things are a little more abstract now, less easily defined, so I think to what extent we could call hip-hop a movement, it's a little more scattered. I don't see the same kind of unity. I don't see the same kind of, not only unity, but uniformity of message across the board. I see a lot of us struggling to identify the goals, the political goals that were a little more easily identified before.
Give me an example on that.
Well, I mean, whether it was something as clear-cut as Back to Africa, or whether it's something as clear-cut as ending segregation in public spaces, or whether it's something about equality and pay, gender equality, racial equality. It seemed a little bit more clearly defined in the past because the obstacles were that much more easily seen. Today, particularly now with President Obama, things are a little bit more complicated. I mean, even just in the recent fact that this is, you know, we're coming to the end of Black History Month, I actually did a LexisNexis search of this issue and found that Barack Obama had not mentioned Black History Month in anything on the public record. But there was a lot of there were a lot of articles and statements about should we get rid of Black History Month, which is an annual thing anyway, annual question. But now that we have a Black president, a lot of people, Black and white, conservative and more progressive, were raising this question. So I think today the things are a little bit more hard to define, even though I think the issues are still just as clear. For me, it seems that the movement or the folks struggling to build a movement are having a harder time identifying issues around which we can actually build. So what should be pretty simple, like police brutality or still the racial gaps in wealth and income, mass incarceration, and so on, should be easily defined. I think that the times have shifted to the point where the popular image encourages us to do less radical critique and less social movement and organizing. And you know, we're sort of into a thing where it seems more an artist might come out and support something that's more or less mainstream, whether it's a presidential candidate or whether it's something different than that. But and then we call that a movement, and I don't know that that's really a movement. A movement has to really involve grassroots organizing. It's not just sending an email. It's not just posting something on a blog. It's not just even making a song. It's actually grassroots organizing, being in the streets, engaging the power structures, looking to even shut down the normal flow of business in society. And I don't know that I see that in hip-hop so much. My name is Fred.